I want to give you a look at three of our top legislative priorities for the summer session. First, we'll be using legislative tools to ensure that students at York University are protected in the face of the ongoing labor dispute.
That was Progressive Conservative House Leader Todd Smith saying the Tories will move forward to end the strike at York University by introducing a back-to-work legislation.
Our students are not bargaining chips. Their futures should not be held for ransom. We intend to use legislative tools to ensure that the interests of the students and their families come first and the students can get back to class for this fall.
The strike, which has been underway since March, is the longest in York University's history. The Ontario PCs now want to put an end to it by making it a top priority in a summer sitting of the Ontario Legislature. The previous Liberal government's attempt to legislate them back to work failed when introduced just before the June 7 election campaign began, with Andrew Horvath's New Democrats strongly opposed.
I mean, it is very disheartening, and clearly it's disappointing. It's not just disappointing for our members who do have these charter rights, but it's also disappointing for students.
Devin Lefebvre is a chairperson for Local QP 3903, which represents contract faculty, teaching assistants, and graduate assistants at York University. He says this isn't a long-term solution, and he believes an agreement can be made.
Back-to-work legislation doesn't actually solve the problems. It's just a way of papering over the problems for another time. So the difficulty with being legislated back to work is not only the uncertainty around what the collective agreement will look like, what this will mean for our members, but it's also not clear what this will mean for students.
As for those students, one thing that is certain is that the strike has been going on for far too long.
I don't feel like they should get forced. I feel like they should come to a decision together. But to be honest, it's not looking like that. It's been, a good 6 months.
I think that as long as it's, they're able to reach some kind of mediated conclusion, I think that's the best bet. I mean, it's been going on for quite a while now, so I don't think it's such a bad idea to do something to try to stop it, maybe to rethink the way that they're thinking about the entire thing, because what they're doing right now doesn't seem to be working.
I was taking a year course last term, and that course is coming back this summer, when I could have finished it in April. Like, I'm still waiting for a mark for that course.
We reached out to the university, and in an email, they tell City News they won't be commenting on the government's legislative plans regarding back-to-work legislation.
Now, the situation at York University is expected to be addressed during the throne speech on Thursday. A back-to-work legislation would see the end to the strike in a week or so. At York University, I'm Nitish Bissonauth, City News.